In part one of our lesson on the fundamental identities, you will create a review of the fundamental identities. So far this semester, you've learned many identities, so I thought it would be a great idea to give you a one-page reference sheet for all the identities we've been using. Let's start with the reciprocal identities. We know that sine of theta is 1 over the cosecant of theta, which means that the cosecant of theta is equal to 1 over the sine of theta, which means that if I take sine of theta times cosecant of theta, I'm going to get 1, because a number times its reciprocal is equal to 1. We know that cosine of theta is equal to 1 over the secant of theta, which means that secant of theta is equal to 1 over the cosine of theta, which means that cosine theta times secant theta is equal to 1. Tangent of theta is equal to 1 over the cotangent of theta. Therefore, cotangent theta is equal to 1 over the tangent of theta. So then when we multiply tangent theta times cotangent theta, we know we're going to get 1. And now remember what all these identities mean. When two expressions are equal to each other, that means they can be substituted for each other anywhere. So anywhere I see a 1 over cosecant theta, I can trade it for a sine theta. Anywhere I see tangent theta times cotangent theta, I can trade it for a 1. Anytime I see 1 over cosine theta, I can trade it for a secant theta. And that's going to be the power of using the identities in this chapter. Next up, we have the quotient identities. And we know that tangent of theta is equal to the quotient of sine theta over cosine theta. And cotangent theta is equal to cosine theta divided by sine theta. So again, we can make those substitutions. Anywhere I see a cotangent theta, I could write instead cosine theta over sine theta, or vice versa. Next up, we have the Pythagorean identities, and we know we have sine squared of theta plus cosine squared of theta is equal to 1. Now, from that identity, you can write this in two very useful forms. One where we solve for sine squared, and one where we solve for cosine squared. So an equivalent form of this identity is to say that sine squared of theta is equal to 1 minus cosine squared of theta, or cosine squared of theta is equal to 1 minus the sine squared of theta. Now, to get the next Pythagorean identity, just start with this one, and in your mind, what you're going to think of doing is dividing by cosine squared of theta. Because if you do that, you can get the other ones very easily. Sine squared divided by cosine squared is going to give you tangent squared of theta plus cosine squared divided by cosine squared is 1, 1 divided by cosine squared is secant squared theta. So that gives you the second Pythagorean identity just by picturing this one in your mind and dividing by cosine squared. Now this identity already has the secant squared by itself. We can have a second form of this identity where we get the tangent squared by itself. So this would be tangent squared theta is equal to secant squared theta minus 1. Next, to get the third Pythagorean identity, once again, start from the main Pythagorean identity, and this time we're going to, in our mind, divide by the sine squared of theta. Now, if we do that, sine squared divided by sine squared is 1. Cosine squared divided by sine squared is cotangent squared theta. 1 divided by sine squared theta is going to be cosecant squared theta. This one is already solved for cosecant squared, so now an alternate form of this one is to solve it for cotangent squared theta, which will then equal cosecant squared theta minus 1. And throughout the semester, you're going to use all versions of these to make substitutions. Next up, we have the negative angle identities. And to help you see the relationships between these identities, I wanted to remind you about the unit circle. And remember that on the unit circle, x is the cosine of theta, and y is the sine of theta. So then, when we have sine of negative theta, what you want to do is see how that would compare to sine of theta. The y value of theta and the y value of negative theta are opposites of each other. So then that means the sine of negative theta is going to be the opposite of sine theta. Now we know that the reciprocal of sine is cosecant. So if we think of cosecant of negative theta, we know that that is just the reciprocal of the y values. And so once again, those are just going to be opposites of each other. So cosecant of negative theta will be negative cosecant theta. Cosine of negative theta, we want to know how that compares to cosine of theta. Now if we look at the angle theta, its x value is x. If we look at negative theta, its x value is the same thing, exactly x. Because if we drop a vertical line here, we see that theta and negative theta, those two points on the terminal sides there, are going to have the same x value. So that means that the cosine of negative theta is exactly equal to the cosine of theta. We know then we can extrapolate that for the secants, because the secant is just going to be the reciprocal of the x values. Well, if the x values are the same, then the reciprocals of those x values will be the same. So that means that secant of negative theta is going to equal secant theta. If we look at tangent of negative theta, we know that tangent is y over x. So here, this is going to be negative y over x. Here, it's going to be y over x. Those numbers are opposites of each other. So tangent of negative theta is negative tangent theta. And we can extrapolate that to the cotangent, because the cotangent is just the x value divided by the y value. So we can see that the cotangent at negative theta is going to be the opposite of the cotangent at theta. So we have cotangent negative theta equals negative cotangent theta. Lastly, we have the cofunction identities. And remember, we learned a little sentence we could say to help us remember that. And that is that cofunctions of complementary angles are equal. So the way we can use that is to say that sine of theta is going to equal the cofunction of its complementary angle. So the cofunction of sine is cosine. The complementary angle, we know that complementary angles add up to be 90 degrees. Now, if we're in radians, then that means those angles would add up to be pi over 2. So solving for the complementary angle then means that it would be pi over 2 minus theta. Likewise, we can say that cosine theta is going to be equal to its cofunction, which is sine, of the complementary angle, which is pi over 2 minus theta. Tangent of theta is going to equal the cofunction of its complementary angle, so cotangent of pi over 2 minus theta, which means we can do the same thing in the reverse order and say that the cotangent of theta will be its cofunction, which is tangent, of the complementary angle, pi over 2 minus theta. Secant of theta is going to equal its cofunction, which would be cosecant, of the complementary angle, pi over 2 minus theta. And we can do that one in the reverse order. Cosecant theta will equal its cofunction, which is secant, of the complementary angle, pi over 2 minus theta. And so now we've created a one-page summary of the fundamental identities that you're going to use to simplify expressions and to learn more identities throughout the chapter. Now, one thing I will really strongly recommend to you is that you write these identities down every day, 2 or 3 times. I know that's a little bit tedious, and it's not a very fun, exciting thing to do, but it will really help you get them down. Because one of the most important things that you're going to need is to be very fluent in all of these identities.